Hey guys, this is Ariana, and in this video, I will talk about how you can use FootyStats to consistently find high-value upcoming fixtures for corners. In corner betting, you can make bets on multiple markets. The advantage of betting in corner markets is that the outcome of the game or the number of goals scored does not matter in settling these bets. Some popular betting markets for corners are handicap, halftime, total, corner raise first two, first and last corner, and in-play corners. Corners are often more predictable than other markets, but detailed research is needed. We provide a list of popular leagues and teams with high average corners as well as a variety of statistics to assist you with your next corner bet. A good analysis of the data can lead to profit, so let's look at them together and see how they can help you increase your chances of winning. The first table lists the 215 best teams for corner predictions. These teams have the highest number of corners won of any team in any league in the currently active season. I will typically go for teams towards the top of this table, playing a side that have conceded an above average amount of corners. You can also view the top teams for corners for and corners against. Total corners is the easiest market in corner betting. In a game, you can predict whether the number of corners will be over, under, or an exact number. But it's best to stick to over and under predictions, as predictions on the exact number carry much higher risk. We can also see on this table that Adelaide United has an average corners of 12.14 per match, and their next match has an odds of 1.52 for over 9.5 corners, with an 86% for the next match. Since we should gather more data, we can also click on this team and view their home and away stats. The average for over 9.5 corners played at home is 50%, while 100% of the matches played at away have resulted in over 9.5. Since their previous matches have resulted in 100% of over 6.5 and 7.5 corners, their corner stats look pretty good. And if we take a look at their upcoming match, we can see that Adelaide United is playing away, and they have a much higher average of corners compared to Wellington Phoenix. Therefore, I'm fairly certain that Adelaide will have more corners, and I could place a corner match bet for this team, as well as keep an eye out for over 9.5 corner bets. If we go back and take a look at our second table, this table lists the top 200 teams with the most corners in first half or the second half of fixtures, ranked by the average first half and second half corners totaled with both teams. These stats are useful for predictions on half with most corners. Since we took a look at Adelaide United before, let's take a look at Borneo this time, which is listed fifth on the list for half with most corners with odds of 2.2 for over 9.5. Taking a look at the corner stats for Borneo FC, we can see that they have an average of 11 corners per match. Their full-time data shows 100% over 6.5 corners overall, with a pretty good percentage throughout. And if we take a look at their first and half stats, we can also see that they have an average of 5.2 corners in the first half when playing at home, and 6.83 when playing away. Corners in the first half are just a bit more than total corners in second half. However, in a game played by this team, more corners result in the first half when played at away games, and so I would bet on corners occurring most often in the first half based on their previous performances, especially if this team's next match is played away. We can move on to our third table. So this table lists the matches with the highest corners potential, and the top 5 teams have a probability of 80% or more of over 9.5 corners. Meaning that most of the teams listed on this table have earned over 5 corners each per match. Looking at the head-to-head stats of Bundaya versus Manama, we can see that Bundaya has earned an average of 3.75 corners per match, while Manama has an average of 7.75. This brings the average to 11.42, and this is calculated based on the team's average corner kicks per match between both teams. There are total corner stats, so a good average for most number of corners. And looking at the odds for under and over, I would say betting on over 9.5 or under 9.5 corners for their next match would be difficult to decide between, but ultimately over 9.5 seems like the better option. And we can move on to our next table. So for a corners match bet, you can bet on the team which will get the most corners in a game. This table lists the leagues with the highest average corner kicks per game. You can look into the corners detailed stats of each of the leagues and look out for matches where the top teams for corners play. This table will be discussed in detail under the leagues with the most corners section later on in this video. The corners over market is one of the most popular methods of prediction. We also cover markets for over 10.5, 11.5, and 12.5 corners, and you can sort the data by percentage of corners, recency, and odds. Now, this table here shows us the over 9.5 corners as well as their respective odds. For today, let's take a look at the example of Triple V. It has 88% of over 9.5 corner stats, which means that in 88% of the games played by this team, 10 or more than 10 corner kicks occurred. Further, they have an odds of 1.69. Now, this combination of over 9.5 percentage and odds looks like a favorable bet to me. Let us click on this team to look at the detailed view of their corner stats. So this page shows us the respective stats for Triple V. And since we're focusing on the corners in the session of our video, we can simply look at the corner stats for Triple V. They have an average of 11.89 corners per match. For the first half of the average of corners kicks between Triple V and their opponent is 5.31. However, this increases to 7 corner kicks in the second half of the game. Since the percentage of corners are quite decent for over 6.5, 7.5, 8.5, and 9.5, I would not mind placing my bet on this team for the upcoming game. We can go on to our next table. Now, this table here shows us the leagues with the most corners. As the name suggests, we can find the names of the leagues, their respective corners per match, the over 9.5 corners percentages, as well as the progress. If you look at this table, as of now for Denmark under 19, it has an average of 11.67 corners occurring per game, with 63% of over 9.5 corners kicks, which means that in 63% of the games played under this league, 10 or more than 10 corners occurred. Let's click on this league and get more detailed stats. Now, after clicking on this league, we can see all the teams playing under this league, their respective match points, and over 9.5, over 7.5, and so forth for their corners kicks percentages. As we go down the page, we can see the table showing total corners for and total corners against for the teams playing under this league. While I place a bet for corner stats for a particular team, I would also like to check the relevant first half corner and second half corner tables. Having a look at the table showing the total corners on the home and away side will also make me more firm in my choice I make for my upcoming corners bet. And as we go down, we can see that FootyStats provides its users with the frequent total corner stats per match. This table reveals the grand total between home and away teams. FootyStats ran an analysis on a total number of 288,030 matches in the database to come up with the most frequently occurring total corners numbers in a match. Further, the data here reveals that 8 to 11 corners are the most common in an average match. However, we can't deny the fact that corners can vary widely between teams across all leagues. To make the best out of your corner predictions, cross-referencing these stats to inform yourself on the best teams and leagues will increase your chances at making corners prediction and winning bets. The top 20 competitors for corners in the first half and second half of the game are listed at the bottom of the page, which makes it easy to see matches played by these leagues. And due to the popularity of the Premier League, we have listed the league's teams based on the average corners numbers and makes it easier to view the teams in the league and upcoming matches to place bets on. One extra tip is to look at the possession average for each team. Teams can't have corners if they don't have the ball. If we use Liverpool as an example, you can see that they have an average of 62% possession per game, 61% when playing at home, and 64% playing away. It's also more likely that the more possession a team has, the more corners they will have. With an average of 10.79 corners, high possession, and as listed at number 3 in the Premier League, I would keep an eye on this team for corners betting. And that's it for this video. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback, feel free to reach out to our Twitter or comment them down below on our YouTube, and we'll try to reach out as soon as possible. Thank you for watching till the end.